They call it the graveyard of the Pacific for a reason. Some 2,000 ships have gone down here. And these guys are out in it 365 days a year.
Oceanographer Bob Ballard is on the Columbia River Bar at the mouth of the Columbia River, located at the border of Washington and Oregon. The Columbia River Bar consists of a series of submerged sandbars and shoals, making the area an invisible obstacle course for incoming boats. For that reason, Bob's come with Dan Jordan, a professional ship pilot and local expert who guides foreign sea captains through this dangerous waterway.
So, typical day at the office for you?
Typical day, yep.
The ship pilot helps navigate precisely where the currents are most likely to change. Today, he's here to help steer the six-story supertanker. But with nowhere to land, Bob and Dan must board by rope.
Man's going out the cabin door. Man is out the cabin door. Man's going down. Man's going down.
Once on board, they quickly find their way to the bridge to help navigate the tanker through the dangerous 3-mile transit.
You know, you can steer your ship all the way around the world, but you need a pilot for the last stretch. The currents change, they're changing all the time, and only the pilot knows which route to take on any given day.
Around the globe, the ocean's currents are in constant motion, and the massive current system driving them is known as the global conveyor belt. These red and blue markers represent the global conveyor belt's flow around the world. The blue indicates the path of its deep, cold water currents, and the red indicates the path of its warmer, surface currents. The conveyor belt begins in the North Atlantic, near Greenland and Iceland, where cold water sinks to the ocean floor. Then, like a giant deep-sea river, it flows through underwater ridges, trenches, and vast plains as it moves southward down the coast of South America.
By the time this current reaches the Southern Ocean, it gets massive. There's no landmass to block it, so it builds and builds and ultimately flows with the volume of 100 Amazon rivers.
Down here, the world's seawater blends together extremely slowly, with deep cold water currents moving only a fraction of an inch every second, and shallow warm water currents passing toward the surface. And as the water circles back up the Atlantic, it's a warm, shallow current that returns north.
When it gets to the tropics, it starts to warm up and begins heading back home. The whole circuit takes 1,000 years.
The continual cycling of all this heat and energy affects everything from daily weather forecasts to long-term climate change. And any small changes to the current can have enormous consequences.
We're now hearing that rising atmospheric temperatures are going to alter the ocean circulation pattern. And Europe, for example, will get colder and colder. But we're not really going to know until we better understand how the entire system works.
Whether it's wind, tides, currents, or the collective swishing of billions of fishtails, understanding the forces that move the ocean is crucial to predicting how the climate will change.
You know, it's truly amazing. We know the ocean currents have a direct impact on our climate. Yet we don't know exactly where all those currents are. Despite our efforts to model the climate, it's just a prediction.
But for Bob, there's a clear trend.
The world's getting hotter, and that's putting more energy into the system. So from there, you just have to follow the trail, and that leads you to more violent storms and bigger waves. Whether you like it or not, global warming is happening. And we know that humans are behind at least some of this heat, and maybe a lot of it. So really, we have two choices. We can move to higher ground, design stronger ships, and build higher seawalls. Or we face the facts and stop adding more heat to the system